Hello, everybody. Welcome to Morning English. This is Blair.
Hi, guys. This is Cici. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
哎，贝贝啊，We're now in the year of the rabbit. 今年啊，可以说是很全新、很特别了。因为很多重要的事情啊，都发生了巨大的改变。For example, there's no health code anymore. We don't have to scan that everywhere we go.
Right. And going abroad, going out for a trip, is getting normal again.
是的。So for the whole new year, do you have any plans for yourself?
Of course. I already set many goals for myself.For example, I'm definitely going to Thailand this year. 想去很久的泰国呢，就是今年一定要完成的一个计划。So, what about you? Have you ever thought about it?
Absolutely. I got so many things that I want to accomplish this year. For example, going abroad for a trip, just like you said.
Yeah, I just miss those traveling times.
Yeah.
They're all happy and great memories. For example, the trip in Hainan. 每次我都会想起在海南拍的那张特别好看的照片啊。
Uh-huh.
Like the skies are blue and the sunshine is so warm.
And your smile is so sweet and beautiful. 哎，贝贝啊，我发现呢，我们刚刚聊天啊，一不小心就用了四次 for example 了。
Yes.
那在口语当中啊，只会用 for example 去举例，是不是不太好呀？
Right. 如果只会用一个 for example， 多少会显得词汇量比较单一和匮乏了啊。其实呢，除了 for example， 还有很多非常实用的表达可以用来举例。So how about we make it our topic today?
Cool. Let's do it.
Okay. So let's see the first one.For instance, instance, I-N-S-T-A-N-C-E. Instance means an example of a particular kind of situation, 也就是例子这个意思啊。然后 for instance, 它在牛津词典上的解释就是 for example.、
Huh.
所以基本上 for instance 和 for example 是可以换用的。
Okay, 那我们来看一个例句啊。I can play quite a few musical instruments. For instance, the drums, the guitar, and the piano.
Oh, really? Cici 有这么多才艺傍身啊。That's amazing.
Absolutely not. 只是举个例子啦。鼓呢，我还是不会的。I've always wanted to learn that though. Well, actually, I want to learn all the musical instruments,、mm-hmm. including violin and cello.
Oh, that's a lot.
Yeah.
真的是有很多的爱好哎。
对。
那刚刚用到的这个举例的表达就是 including, I-N-C-L-U-D-I-N-G. So it's used for saying that a person or thing is part of a particular or amount. 有包含的意思，所以呢也可以用来举例。
对啊，比如说呢，有一篇外刊当中啊，就有这样一句话 ,The digital world also harbors new risks, including cyberbullying and sexting.
对，诶，这句话的意思就是说，数字世界也潜藏着新的危机，比如说网络霸凌和调情短信。那这里用的就是 including 来引出来 cyberbullying, 网络霸凌和 sexting, 调情短信这两个例子。
Yeah, 像是 cyberbullying, 其实现在啊，就时常会出现耶。I think maybe platforms such as Weibo and Douyin need to do more to prevent that.
Right, but I don't think that's easy. 毕竟现在在网络上抨击评论他人的门槛太低了。
Yeah.
那你刚刚就用到了一个很好的例子啊 ,such as, 这个也是口语当中会用到的一个非常高频的表达。
对的。Okay, so Blair,、mm-hmm. I heard that you know four languages, such as...Japanese and English, is that true?
Where did you get that message? 有时候我们办公室真的会传很多的谣言啊 ,ranging from my language skills to my family background.
Okay, now you just bring up another one, ranging from to.
Yes.
Ranging 呢它的原型是 R-A-N-G-E, 表示呢范围的意思 ,ranging from to.表达的啊，就是包含了什么到什么，所以呢，也可以用来举例子。
对，像之前啊，关于王力宏嫖娼，就有一篇这样子的文章。So 2 days after the famous crooner announced he was divorcing his wife, Lee posted a 9-page response on Instagram, alleging a long list of Lee Holmes' indiscretion, ranging from infidelity to prostitution.
也就是说啊，著名歌手王力宏呢宣布离婚的两天之后，他的前妻李静蕾啊在 ins 上发布了长达九页的控诉信啊，指责呢他有出轨和招妓这些不检点的行为。
对，然后这里作者就是用了 ranging from to 来引出不检点的行为 indiscretion 的两个例子 infidelity 出轨和 prostitution 招妓。
是的，然后像最近啊，我不是在带早安的同学们学习美剧 Desperate Housewife 吗？
嗯，
里面啊也有这样一句话， Dr. Albert Goldfein was the most accomplished marriage counselor in the city. He had dealt with problems ranging from substance abuse to infidelity to domestic violence.
啊，那这里是说这位叫做 Albert 的博士啊，他是最厉害的婚姻咨询师，他成功的解决了像嗑药、出轨、家庭暴力这些婚姻问题。那这里呢就举了三个例子，就是用 ranging from to 来表达。
是的，听完这两个例子之后啊，发现呢一段婚姻中的问题还是有点多啊。No wonder people tend to get married late.
单身苦，单身拽，单身不怕被人甩。诶，那今天呢我们就来最后啊再看一个同样可以用来举例的表达，就一个单词、
okay.
而且我们口语当中出现的频率也极高。 Say
Say就是我们说话的这个 say 吗？
Exactly, 就是说话的这个 say, S-A-Y. 比如啊，我们通过一个例子来看一下。对于网络游戏风靡，外刊呢就有这么一句报道。Indeed, their game use may be a symptom of some other underlying problem, say social phobia or depression.
啊，这句话的意思啊，是说呢，人们现在沉迷游戏可能呢是其他深层问题的一些表现啊、
嗯、
比如说什么样子的深层问题呢，这里就用 say 举了两个例子， social phobia 社交恐惧症和 depression 抑郁。
是的，哎，那我们今天就讲了这么多可以用来替换 for example 的表达、
yeah.
那我们最后再来带大家一起回顾一下。 For instance, including, such as, ranging from to, and say。
是的，那你还知道哪些也可以用来举例的英文表达吗？欢迎来留言框和我们交流哦。
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
And so that's all we have for today. So thank you so much for listening. This is Cici.
And this is Blair. See you next time.
Bye. Bye.